What's up, YouTube? It's the Hero of Tomorrow, and I'm gonna be real with you. Today's episode of the Hero of Tasting was not originally meant to be its own thing, but I kinda decided to do it out of necessity. See, right now, I have just finished working on the final Cartoon Hero episode. It's been uploaded unlisted to YouTube, just to make sure that YouTube's ad bots aren't going to claim it. Because I went over that thing with a fine-tooth comb. I tried to keep any copyrighted material in it less than 7 seconds long, and I mirrored the footage whenever I was able to. Usually, I try to do it when there wasn't text on screen, but sometimes I couldn't avoid that. I really just didn't want it to get demonetized so I could actually host it on my YouTube channel. Because a lot of people keep saying that all I do is upload trailers to my YouTube channel. And trust me, I would upload them here if I could. But YouTube is bullshit about copyright. We've known this for a long time now. I had originally planned on tasting these drinks live for the first time on a stream, because once the last episode of the Cartoon Hero Reviews goes live on Friday, although for the early access patrons, it'll be later today, so y'all get to see it ahead of everyone else. Anyway, I was planning on doing a stream after the last episode goes live for everyone. It'll be a couple of days after that because this weekend I have plans for the 4th of July and everything, because we're going to be spending it with some of my relatives. They're celebrating early because 4th of July is on a Thursday this year. Anyway, I wanted to let you know that during the time that videos haven't been being uploaded to this channel, I have not been idle, because I've actually filmed about 3 different reviews. The first is quite obviously the last Cartoon Hero episode, and that took me about 10 days to edit because it was basically going back through my entire review series as a whole, and spoilers, the episode itself is over 1.5 hours long, so yeah, it took me a while to put together. But I have also filmed a couple of Patreon requests, one being the Wild Thornberries movie, and another being Team America, the latter of which I'm hoping to premiere on the actual 4th of July, because these episodes don't take nearly as much time to edit as that last Cartoon Hero episode did. Anyway, with all of that said, I thought that I would put up something that was very quick and very easy, but something that I've been planning on doing for a while. Because today on The Hero of Tasting, we're going to be talking about some weird Diet Coke flavors. You see, I drink Diet Coke. I know a lot of people don't enjoy it, but I do. In fact, I can't even drink regular Coke anymore for the most part. It's just too sweet to me. I guess it comes from trying to watch my weight, even though some people would argue that diet soda is even worse for you. And to those people I will say, you can take my diet soda when you pry it from my cold dead hands. Anyway, whenever I go to Walmart, I usually end up seeing these weird offshoot Diet Cokes on the soft drink aisle next to the regular stuff. And I have to say, some of them looked intriguing. Because I like Diet Coke, but I also like it when different flavors are infused into it, usually. I usually love it when cherry flavor is put into my drink. I usually get cherry injected into my drink whenever I go to Sonic. By the way, the Sonic in Heber Springs is massive. I don't know if any of you have ever seen a Sonic with a McDonald's-style play place in front of it, but this Sonic has one, and it's a little bit weird to me. I don't guess there's a lot of other choices around here, but still. So I've actually been saving these for a while, getting them whenever I had a little bit of spare money whenever I go to the grocery store, just because they made me a little bit curious. And there are some flavors out there that I wasn't able to get. There's a strawberry guava flavor, which doesn't sound appealing to me, but there's also a blueberry acai Diet Coke, which I never seem to see in the actual store. And if any of you know where to get it, could somebody please send that to my P.O. box? I'm legitimately asking. Anyway, like I said, I love cherry flavored drinks, so of course this was the one that caught my eye first, because this is Diet Coke Feisty Cherry. Now, at first I was like, cool, a Diet Coke that actually has cherry in it? But what I didn't read was that it's not exactly just cherry. because it has cherry flavor and chili injected into it. I'm imagining they're not referring to the food, but the chili pepper, which I've heard that some people like their drinks with spice in them. I'm not one of those people, but if it has cherry in it and it's Diet Coke, then I'm willing to give it a bit of a try. So that's exactly what I'm gonna do today. Okay, I am back with the box open and a glass of ice because it is a scientific fact that most drinks taste better cold. And usually, Diet Coke tastes better on the rocks. So, let's see if that's true of this. Smells like Diet Coke. It does have a little bit of a spicy tang to the smell, but I'm willing to give it a try still. Let's pour it on. It smells like cherry Coke, but it's still got that little bit of a spicy tang in it. Okay, it looks enough like Diet Coke. I mean, I guess it is, but it's kind of a new sensation to me. When I sniffed it earlier, the bubbles tickled my nose a lot more than they usually do. Like, they kind of burned a little. It's weird. I mean, I guess that's the chili, but I didn't think it would be that strong of a chili flavor. All right, moment of truth, bottoms up. It basically tastes like cherry Coke. Like, it does have a little bit of a heated edge to it, but it's not that bad. I mean, I was expecting it to be a lot spicier, but I guess a lot of people don't want spice in their soda. Yeah, I think I'll finish this. This is actually pretty good. I wasn't expecting that. Well then, that's a pleasant surprise. Okay, little bit of an update. At first, I could definitely taste a chili, spicy aftertaste to it, but it wasn't that great at first. But the more I drank of it, of course, the more the taste stacked up. So basically, the more you drink of this stuff, the spicier it gets. And admittedly, it's not so spicy that it's not palatable, but yeah, you can definitely feel it after a while. It still has the same flavor of cherry Diet Coke, which I like, but the fact that it has that extra chili flavor to it means you gotta sip it a bit more cautiously than I normally would drink a Diet Coke. Like I said, it's not so bad to the point where it's not palatable. It's just a bit weird compared to what I'm used to. I'm guessing that's not bad, but I am gonna drink this. I'm just gonna sit it aside for now because I've got more stuff to do and I don't wanna force myself to drink it all at once, because if I do, then it might become a little bit more spicy than I want my soda to be. So as such, now we have the second weird Diet Coke flavor that I grabbed, Zesty Blood Orange. Now, the last time that I tried a drink that was Jamaican blood orange flavored, it didn't turn out that well. Like, maybe I'm just not used to blood oranges. Oranges are normally one of my favorite flavors, but it just didn't do it for me. However, let's see how it does when it's mixed with Diet Coke. As you can see, I have another glass just for this because I didn't want to waste it. Smells like Diet Coke with a hint of orange. So, let's pour that on in. Okay, now I have a full glass of Zesty Blood Orange Diet Coke, and let's see what the verdict on this one is. It's not bad. It certainly tastes different than a regular orange, obviously, because it's a blood orange. It's a little sweeter and a little spicier than an orange normally is. I think it's closer to grapefruit, although not nearly as overpowering as the taste of grapefruit is. Yeah, I gotta say, this isn't normally a flavor that I would associate with being together with Diet Coke. Again, it's not bad. It's just something that I thought I would try when I was running out of Diet Coke at home, and I thought, well, maybe this'll do in a pinch, and it certainly will. It's just, I don't know. Usually when it comes to blending flavors with Diet Coke, I would go with cherry or vanilla or maybe lime if I was feeling a bit off that day. So neither of these flavors were particularly mind-blowing. Feisty Cherry has some things I like about it and some things I don't, while Zesty Blood Orange really isn't all that zesty, to be honest. It's not great, but it's not bad either. I really am curious about that Blueberry Acai flavor because I actually do like candy that's flavored like that, so maybe I'll like Diet Coke that's flavored with that. I don't know, like I said, this was just a weird experiment that I thought I would try, and maybe I'll try the Strawberry Guava if I'm not running low on cash at the moment, but it's not really a flavor that sounds particularly appetizing to me, so who knows. Either way, this has been The Hero of Tasting. I'm The Hero of Tomorrow, and thank you all for watching.